Good morning, students. Today, let us start a new lesson. The lesson name is Current Electricity. Current Electricity. So far, we studied about electric charge, which is at rest. When we have electric charge, if it is at rest, the study of electric charge at rest is called electrostatics. This is our first lesson, what we completed, electrostatics. Now the charge come to the state of motion. Again, motion means here you have two conditions. Charge may move with constant speed, charge may move with variable speed. That means velocity is constant or velocity is not constant. If charge is moving with constant speed, it constitutes electric current. Electric current is defined as, electric current is defined as rate of flow of electric charge. Rate of flow of electric charge. If suppose I is the letter used to represent electric current, if Q is the charge flown within a time interval of T, Q by T is called electric current. So when electric charge is moving with constant speed, it constitutes electric current. The study of electric current is called current electricity. That means study of electric charges under motion with constant speed is called current electricity. If the charge moves with variable speed, that means it possesses non-zero acceleration, then it creates some magnetic field, hence it generates electromagnetic waves. We will study about these electromagnetic waves in coming lessons. In this current lesson, we are going to study about current electricity. Can you say what is current electricity? Current electricity is the study of electric charges under motion with constant speed. What is electric current? Electric current is defined as charge flown by time taken. If you take the units for this, charge is measured in coulomb, time is measured in seconds. Coulomb per second is called ampere. By the name of scientist, they gave this unit ampere. So simply you can write I is equal to Q by T amperes. Electric current is equal to charge by time amperes. Here we will define two types of currents. If suppose there is a conductor, this conductor is having some cross section here. dA is the area of cross section through which delta Q is the charge flowing in a time delta T. Delta Q is the charge flowing in a time delta T. You can represent either small q or capital Q, no problem. The total charge flowing delta Q by total time taken, this is called average current. This is called average current. What is the definition of average current? Total charge flown by total time taken. Total charge flown by total time taken is called average current. Similarly, if I take limit to the time interval, the same total charge by total time taken observed for a short interval of time, then it is called dq by dt as per mathematics. In physics, it is called instantaneous current. Instantaneous current is defined as limit delta t tends to 0, delta q by delta t. That is nothing but dq by dt. The definition of instantaneous current is the current passing through a conductor at a particular instant of time. That means you need to calculate the average current over a short interval of time. At a particular instant of time, the amount of current passing through it is called instantaneous current. Instantaneous current is represented as dq by dt. So you have to remember the definition of electric current. Electric current is charge flown by time taken. Average electric current is total charge flown by total time taken. Instantaneous electric current is derivative of charge with respect to time. As you know that electric current is one of the fundamental physical quantities, we may have a doubt whether it is a scalar or vector. generally it is having certain magnitude. Current flows from negative terminal of the positive terminal of the battery to negative terminal of the battery. So it is having direction as well as magnitude. So you may think it as vector, but it is not a vector quantity. Electric current is not a vector quantity. Electric current is a scalar quantity. Let us see how we can call it as scalar quantity. Electric current as scalar quantity. If you see, 2 amperes of current is passing through this conductor, 3 amperes of current is passing through this conductor. One more conductor is attached here. If you want to calculate the current passing through this, you should if you calculate, it will get you will get a value 5 amperes. If suppose these two conductors are inclined to one another at an angle 60 degrees. If current is a vector quantity, in order to calculate the resultant of these two, we should apply parallelogram law. As per parallelogram law, root of p square plus q square plus 2pq cos theta should be the resultant. But clearly, if you observe here, it is independent of theta. Independent of resultant current is independent of angle between the two conductors. So it doesn't depend on theta value. The resultant current is sum of these two currents. So it is not following laws of vector addition. It is not following parallelogram law. So as it is not following laws of vector addition, electric current can be considered as scalar quantity. Why it is considered as scalar quantity? It doesn't obey laws of vector addition. It doesn't obey laws of vector addition. Hence, electric current is considered as scalar quantity. Similarly, we will take pressure also as scalar quantity. Generally, strictly speaking, electric current can be considered as a tensor quantity. Tensor means in different directions it will have different magnitudes. If suppose in options, in the place of scalar, if they give tensor, this is also right answer. So electric current is a scalar quantity. Now, so far we discussed the definition of electric current and what is average current and what is instantaneous current. Now let us see some applications related to them to have a more clear idea about these quantities. For example, question. The question is like this. The electric charge Q as a function of time they gave like this. Q is equal to T square plus 40 plus 5. Then find I instantaneous current at t is equal to 3 seconds. At a particular instant of time, the current passing through the conductor is called instantaneous current. Also find average current from t is equal to 0 seconds to t is equal to 2 seconds. They gave this question like this. T is equal to 0 seconds to t is equal to 2 seconds. We need to find average current. At t is equal to 3 seconds, we need to find instantaneous current. The solution is quite simple. Solution is like this. You are given electric charge t square plus 4t plus 5. Electric charge is a function of time. Whenever we want instantaneous current, what we discussed? Instantaneous current is derivative of charge with respect to time. That is nothing but d by dt of t square plus 40 plus 5. 5. Now, you know the derivative formula d by dx of x power n is equal to n into x power n minus 1. So based on this formula, this is d by dt of t square, that means 2 into t power 2 minus 1, d by dt of 4t, 4 into derivative of t is 1, derivative of constant is 0. So you will get 2t plus 4 as instantaneous current. Instantaneous current as a function of time. You are asked to find instantaneous current at time t is equal to 3 seconds. When you take time as 3 seconds, the instantaneous current is given by 2 into 3 plus, well, this is 2t plus 4, okay? 2 into 3 plus 4, that is 6 plus 4. The answer is 10 amperes. The answer is 10 amperes. At time t is equal to 3, the current passing through the conductor is 10 amperes, which is nothing but instantaneous current. Now let me calculate average current. I average is defined as the total charge flown by the total time taken. Total charge flown means final charge minus initial charge by final time minus initial time. Final charge in the sense, at 2 seconds the charge at 2 seconds is final charge, charge at 0 seconds is the initial charge, 2 minus 0, that is q 2 seconds. How to calculate? Q as a function of time, we have seen this expression. So here you should substitute in the place of t, 2. So 2 square plus 4 into 2 plus 5. At 0 seconds, t square is 0, 4t is 0, so only you will have 5 by 2. So answer is 4 plus 8 plus 5 minus 5 gets cancelled by 2. That is 12 by 2, 6 amperes. 6 amperes is the average current flown within the time interval of 0 to 2 seconds. 0 to 2 seconds. If you want to draw a graph between current and time, time is on x-axis, current is on y-axis. How to draw? I am taking instantaneous current, this expression into consideration, 2t plus 4. At time t is equal to 0, what will happen? Time t is equal to 0 means instantaneous current is 4 amperes. As time increases, current value gets increases. Suppose time becomes 2 seconds. T is equal to 2 seconds. If you substitute in the place of t, 2, 2 2s are 4 plus 4, 8. So this current value increases to 8 amperes. So if you extend this, you will get 8 amperes here corresponding to this point. So it's a straight line. Clearly, it is in the form of y is equal to mx plus c. Therefore, the variation of current with respect to time follows a straight line path as shown in figure. So in this way, whenever you are given charge, you are able to calculate instantaneous current as well as average current. Let me say one more example for you. Next question. Now you are given electric current I is equal to t square plus 1. Electric current I is equal to t square plus 1. Then find q means charge flown. Q flown from 0 seconds to 2 seconds. 0 seconds to 2 seconds. Also find 0 seconds to 3 seconds. Also find number of electrons flown through the same cross section in the same time. This is the question. The question is, you are given current value, find charge value. Charge that is flown from 0 to 3 seconds. Okay, very simple. Solution is like this. In the earlier problem, charge is given, you are asked to find current. Now, current is given. Current value is given as T square plus 1. You know that electric current instantaneous is nothing but dq by dt. Then it is nothing but I. dq is equal to I dt. In order to remove derivative on both sides, you should use integration. Integral dq is equal to integral I dt. Integral dq is equal to integral I dt. So, as per the given problem, integral dq is q. Derivative and integration gets cancelled. Integral t square plus 1 dt. Here time is the variable. Time varies from 0 to 3 seconds. 0 to 3 seconds. Then you can calculate q like this. Integration 0 to 3 t square dt plus integration 0 to 3 dt. You know the formula. Integral x power n dx is equal to x power n plus 1 by n plus 1. X power n plus 1 by n plus 1. So based on this, it becomes t power 2 plus 1 by 2 plus 1. That is t cube by 3. Limits are from 0 to 3. Integral dt, nothing but t, 0 to 3. It becomes 3 cube by 3 minus 0 plus 3 minus 0. So 3 cube by 3 means 3 square, 9 plus 3. Answer is 12 coulombs. 12 coulombs is the charge flown through the given cross section within the time gap of 0 to 3 seconds. Next, you are asked to find number of electrons flown. You know the formula q is equal to plus or minus n e, or n is equal to q by e. Charge flown is 12 coulombs. Each electron possesses charge 1.6 into 10 power minus 19 coulombs. If you simplify this, coulomb coulomb gets cancelled. You will get the answer 7.5 into 10 power 19. 7.5 into 10 power 19. So this many electrons are to be transferred to get 12 coulombs of charge. So the number of electrons is 7.5 into 10 power 19 electrons. We calculated the number of electrons as per this calculation. Now let us move to the next part. In order to study current electricity, we require some another set of definitions. So let us try to understand the other set of definitions like this. The next kind. Good morning, students. Today, let us discuss two important definitions. One is current density. And the second one is drift velocity. In order to study current electricity, we require these two quantities. Let us understand current density. Current density is represented with a letter J cap. Current density is represented with a letter J cap or J bar. And drift velocity is represented with Vd. Drift velocity is represented with Vd. Current density is represented with J bar. What is the need of current density? Let us understand. You know that electric current is a scalar quantity. electric current I is a scalar quantity. So sometimes if you want to represent current as vector quantity, we introduced J bar. So J bar is a vector quantity. It's a vector quantity. How it is defined? For example, there is some cross section of wire like this. There is some cross section of wire like this. Through this wire, a current is passing. That I is the current passing in this direction. Its area of cross section, let it be A. If you want to represent the area as vector, you should take n cap like this, which is nothing but A into n cap, or A bar. Direction of A bar is like this. If this unit vector is making an angle theta with the direction of current, actually current is a scalar quantity, so if you want to represent it as vector, I am replacing I with J. I am replacing I with J bar. Now, you can define current density like this. Electric current is the scalar product of this J bar and A bar. Electric current is the dot product of J bar and A bar. Our electric current is given by J into A into cos phi. J into A into cos phi. Or you can say J is equal to I by A cos phi. If suppose this angle is 0, eta is equal to 0. That means J bar is parallel to A bar. J bar is parallel to A bar. In that case, current density is given by I by A cos theta. Cos 0 is 1. So J is equal to I by A. So this is the definition of current density. The current density vector whose magnitude is given by strength of electric current passing through the conductor to the area of cross section. The ratio of current passing through the conductor to area of the cross section is called current density, provided current should pass perpendicular to the area of cross section. Area of cross section is like this. Current should pass in this direction. So as current is passing in this direction, the current density vector is represented in this direction. So A bar and J bar are parallel to each other. The current density is defined as current passing through unit area. If area of cross section is 1, the current passing through the area of cross section in normal direction is called current density. How to define current density? Current density is defined as electric current passing through unit area of cross section perpendicular to its surface. Electric current passing through unit area of cross section perpendicular to its surface is called current density. What are the units of current density? Ampere is the unit for current. Area is having meter square. Or simply, area per meter square is the unit for current density. Why we introduce current density? Sometimes it is necessary to represent electric current as a vector quantity. Electric current actually is a scalar. Hence, we introduce a new quantity called current density vector, which is defined as current passing through unit area in normal direction. Current passing through unit area in normal direction. Now, we have to understand the next drift velocity. Here is a conductor. This conductor is attached with a cell. This conductor is attached with a cell. Let E is the EMF of the cell. Whenever you attach this positive terminal to this end and negative terminal to this end gets positive charge, this end gets negative charge, and there exists an electric field inside the conductor from positive terminal to negative terminal. Due to this electric field, whatever molecules available in the material content of the conductor, they are getting ionized. Positive ions and negative electrons are separated. These negative electrons are attracted by the positive
terminal of the battery. In this direction, they will move. The negative positive ions are attracted by the negative terminal of the battery. They are moving like this. Suppose here this is an electron whose charge is E. It is acted upon by some electric field. So it experiences some force. So force experienced by the electron is given by applied electric field into charge of each electron. Charge of each electron is minus E. So it experiences that force. If mass of the electron is M and acceleration of electron is A, force can be replaced with mass into acceleration. That must be equal to EE. Then acceleration is equal to minus EE by M. Acceleration is equal to minus EE by M. Therefore, every electron should accelerate due to the applied electric field. But it will not happen. Why it will not happen? Whenever these electrons are trying to accelerate and to increase their speed, the co-moving electrons are having negative charge, they will obstruct the motion of this particular electron because like charges repel each other. Similarly, once electrons are moving, all the positive ions are moving in the opposite direction. This positive ion may attract this electron, so it will not allow this electron to get accelerated up. So the positive ions are not allowing the electrons to get accelerated up. Even co-moving electrons are also not allowing the electrons to accelerate up. So this acceleration will not continue forever. After some time, this electron, which started from its rest, attains a certain speed and it starts moving with the same speed. That particular speed attained by the electron is called drift speed. That particular speed attained by the electron is called drift speed or drift velocity. Drift velocity. As it is moving in a straight line direction, you can call it as drift speed or drift velocity. Here, what will happen actually, if you observe the motion of a particular electron, the electron will follow a zigzag path like this. Like this it will follow. It may go like this. Suppose a single electron if I take, it will come in a straight line path up to here and it changes its path because of presence of some another electron here. This electron is coming up to here. This is repelled by this particular electron, it is changing its path. Again it is repelled by some another electron here, it changes its path. Again repelled by some another electron, changes its path. It continuously changing its path and it is undergoing multiple collisions and following a zigzag path. So each and every electron will be following its own zigzag path. In this process, it will attain the drift speed. In this process, it will attain the drift speed. Drift speed means the constant speed with which it will be moving inside the conductor due to the repulsions given by the co-moving electrons, due to the attractions given by the positive ions, due to the multiple repulsions and multiple directional path attained by the electron. Finally, all the electrons are moving with a constant speed called drift speed. To calculate the drift speed value, we need to introduce two more terms. One is small d. This is called mean free path, which is called mean free path. Next, we need to introduce one more letter, tau, a Greek letter tau, which is called relaxation time. Relaxation time. First, let us understand what is D. Between one collision and another collision, it is traveling through different distances. In the first collision, it traveled through small distance. In the second collision, this is the distance traveled. In the third collision, this is the distance traveled. In the fourth collision, this is the distance traveled. In each collision, it is traveling through different distances. So if I take the average of all those distances suffered by the electron between two successive collisions, the average distance traveled by an electron between two successive collisions is called mean free path. Is called mean free path. And the average time taken by the electron to undergo successive collisions, that means from here to here it may be taking t1 time, from here to here it is taking t2, from here to here it is taking t3, and so on. If I take the average of all those times suffered by the electron between successive collisions, the average of all those times is called the relaxation time. So once again you see, what is d? Average distance traveled by an electron between successive collisions is called mean free path. What is tau? The average time taken by the electron between successive collisions is called relaxation time. So by knowing these two, we can calculate the drift velocity. Drift velocity is a constant velocity attained by the electron due to the applied electric field or due to the supply of energy by the battery. Let me calculate an expression for drift speed here. You know that according to kinematics, we have two equations. What are the kinematic equations of motion? One is V is equal to U plus AT, another one is S is equal to UT plus half AT. V is equal to UT plus AT means, V is equal to U plus AT means final velocity. Final velocity attained is called drift velocity. It starts from rest, it is moving with an acceleration minus EE by M into T. T is the time taken, average time taken is called relaxation time. Okay? Now, drift velocity is a vector. Only if you want magnitude of drift velocity, you should take modulus of this. So EE by M into W, minus will go in modulus. So drift speed is like this. Here electric field is a vector, so both are in vector form. Here only I took magnitude. Similarly, the average distance traveled is d. It starts from rest, half into acceleration is minus e bar e by m into tau square. Then it is mean free path as a vector. Only if I need magnitude of this, mod d bar is equal to e by 2m into E by 2m into tau square. Now, the drift speed is given by E by m into tau. From this, relaxation time can be calculated. M by E into Vd. This formula you can remember. Otherwise, directly, what is Vd? Vd is nothing but EE by M into tau. EE by M into tau. Both are same. Sometimes you may use this formula. Okay. Now, if you come to current density already I defined it as current passing through unit area in normal direction. You can write it in differential form. What is the differential form? Differential form of this is J is equal to dI by dA. That means dI is the small amount of current passing through a small area. Then the ratio of dI by dA is called J, current density. Otherwise, in integral form, we can write it like this. Integral form. Implies dI is equal to JdA. We are considering this as a vector, this as vector, but current is a scalar term. So then I is equal to integral J bar dot dA bar. Integral J bar dot dA bar. This is the differential form of current density. This is the integral form of current density. Wherever they are required, we are